Hello friends, in this video we are going to discuss about piezoelectric transducer. If you have used a quartz watch or if you have undergone an ultrasound in hospital or if you ever have turned the gas burner with a gas lighter, then you have used a piezoelectric transducer. Let us see more about these piezoelectric transducers. The word piezoelectric is derived from the Greek word piezon. Piezon means to squeeze or to press. So, electricity which is produced due to squeezing or pressing is piezoelectricity. So, the name piezoelectric transducer. Piezoelectric transducer is an active transducer. Why? Because piezoelectric transducer detects the physical quantity that may be a force, pressure, stress or anything and convert it directly into voltage. So, it is a self-generating transducer or active transducer and it does not require an external power source to convert the physical quantity change into an electrical signal. Piezoelectric transducer works on piezoelectric effect. Now let us see what is piezoelectric effect. So, when a suitably cut quartz crystal is subjected to mechanical pressure on one pair of faces, then an equal and opposite charge is developed on other pair of faces, which is known as piezoelectric effect. The piezoelectric effect was first developed by two brothers, Perry and Jacques Curie So, natural piezoelectric crystal have to be cut in a suitable manner. So, if a suitably cut quartz crystal is there, when a mechanical stress is applied along opposite faces of suitably cut quartz crystal, then a potential difference is developed along other two opposite faces of quartz crystal. The crystal which exhibit piezoelectric effect are called as piezoelectric crystal. So we have natural piezoelectric crystals as quartz, tourmaline, Rochelle salt, topaz, bone, cane sugar, DNA. Synthetic piezoelectric materials like lead, zirconium titanate, which is popularly known as PZT, lead titaniate, lead free ceramics just like barium titanate, lanthanum tantalate, lithium niobate, sodium tungstate, polymers like polyvinyldiene difluoride.
The piezoelectric property in synthetic piezoelectric materials is developed by special polarizing treatment. Now, why synthetic piezoelectric materials are preferred over natural piezoelectric crystal? Because synthetic piezoelectric materials has many advantages. Just like they are available in different shapes and sizes, they can work at low voltages and they can operate at temperature more than 300 degrees centigrade. And also they give more output than natural piezoelectric crystal.
The charges in the piezoelectric crystal exactly balance each other, even if they are not symmetrically arranged. The effect of the charge exactly cancel out each other, leaving no net charge on the crystal. More specifically, you can say that the dipole moment, which is nothing but the vector line joining the opposite charges, are randomly oriented and their net dipole moment is zero, or they cancel out each other. But when you squeeze this crystal, you force the charge out of balance. Now, the dipole moments no longer cancel each other, but they get aligned themselves in a particular direction. So, positive charge is developed on one face and negative charge is developed on another face. Now, let us take an example of quartz crystal. So, quartz is nothing but silica, that is SiO2, silicon dioxide. So, it consists of silicon atoms which are positively charged and oxygen atoms which are negatively charged. So, when the crystal is not stressed, it is unstressed, then the electric dipole moments are oriented randomly and they cancel out each other. So, there are no net charges on the faces of the crystal. But when you squeeze the crystal or when you apply a compressive stress to the crystal, then a potential difference is developed with, say, in one direction, having positive charge on one face, negative charge on another face. On the other hand, if you apply tension to this crystal or if you stretch the crystal, then the potential difference is again developed but with another polarity or with opposite polarity. The construction, piezoelectric transducer consists of a crystal which is kept between a solid base and a force summing member F. So, what is force summing member? It consists of all the mechanical elements which are used to convert applied force into displacement. Now, when the pressure on the top surface of crystal is increased, then charges are developed on the opposite faces of crystal, so potential difference is developed, and the magnitude of this potential difference is proportional to the pressure applied. On the other hand, if you decrease the pressure or if you release the pressure, then again the potential difference is developed, but with opposite polarity. The voltage produced also depends on the orientation of the crystal. If the crystal is arranged in a longitudinal direction, then the amount of charge generated Q is given by Q equal to F into D, where F is the applied force and D is the piezoelectric coefficient of the quartz crystal. But if the crystal is arranged in transverse direction, then the applied charge, then the charge developed Q is equal to F into D into B by A, where A and B are the breadth and length of the rectangle. If the ratio B by A is greater than 1, then the voltage produced in transverse effect will be greater than voltage produced in longitudinal effect. We have discussed the piezoelectric effect, that is, when mechanical stress is applied along the opposite faces of crystal, then a potential difference is developed on other pair of faces. So the converse of this effect is also true. Means, what is the most important or magical thing about piezoelectric crystal? That is, they also show inverse piezoelectric effect. So what is inverse piezoelectric effect? So inverse piezoelectric effect states that when an alternating voltage is applied across opposite faces of suitably cut quartz crystal, then the crystal expands and compresses and it vibrates with its natural frequency. We have a piezoelectric crystal which is kept between two metal plates and it is connected to an alternating voltage source. So during positive half cycle, the crystal expands. During negative half cycle, the crystal compresses. Again, during positive half cycle, the crystal expands. During negative half cycle, the crystal compresses. In this way, the crystal is set into mechanical vibration with its natural frequency of vibration, that is N equal to 1 upon 2T under root of Y by rho, where T is the thickness of the crystal, Y is the Young's modulus of the crystal, and rho is the density of the quartz crystal. So thinner the crystal, more will be the frequency of vibration. Piezoelectric ultrasonic transducer consists of a piezoelectric crystal which is kept between two metal plates and is connected to a primary L3 of transformer, which is inductively coupled to an oscillator circuit. The secondary L1 of transformer and the capacitor C1 form the tank circuit of oscillator or tuned circuit of oscillator. When battery is switched on, the oscillator produces high frequency AC voltages which is fed to the metal plate surrounding the crystal due to transformer action. Inverse piezoelectric effect takes place and the crystal is set into mechanical vibration with its natural frequency of vibration. Now, the capacitor C1 of the tank circuit is adjusted in such a way that the frequency of the applied voltage is equal to the natural frequency of the vibration of the crystal, and resonance takes place and ultrasonic waves of high frequencies are generated.
Advantages: piezoelectric transducers have high frequency response, they are self-generating transducers, they have negligible phase shift, they have high output. Piezoelectric transducers are available in desired shape, they are smaller in size, lighter in weight, and they are solid and robust in construction. Piezoelectric transducers have wide number of application. They are used in industries for engine NOx sensors, pressure sensors, sonar equipment, ultrasonic cleaning, ultrasonic welding, piezoelectric motors, medical applications. They are used in ultrasonic imaging, ultrasonic procedures, consumer electronics. They are used in piezoelectric printers, piezoelectric speakers, piezoelectric buzzers, quartz watch, in musical application, instrument pickups, microphones, and they have lot of other applications including piezoelectric lighters, igniters, and tennis rackets.